Hello and welcome to Your News, presented by Chris Hill.
Hello and welcome to Your News. Here are the big stories.
The lovely people we support at Headingley Heart have been very busy of late. They've been putting their artistic talents to good use decorating postcards which have been sent to Ukrainians living in shelters on the Ukraine-Poland border. Let's hope the colourful messages of love and support will bring some happiness to the Ukrainians in their ordeal. We've seen more Valentine's Day arts and crafts than ever before this year. Flowers, hearts, cards, bunting, miniature tree decorating, painted baubles and window art. You've done it all. The romantic mood didn't stop at the craft table. Some of you went along to the Valentine-themed parties or joined in with Julie's Thursday's fun Zoom with singing and dancing, plus entertainment provided by Hillside. Some lucky mothers received beautiful handmade cards for Mother's Day, and at Rainel Drive, Kirsty did some rock painting. We've had flowers everywhere. Huge tissue paper and light board painted ones created at Hall Park, some ones at Airborough Community Base, and stuck to Easter bonnets along with rabbits, ducks and ribbons at Headingley Heart. At Headingley Heart they celebrated St Patrick's Day in style, and we have enjoyed seeing all of the entries for our Decorate an Easter Egg competition. Staff have sent in their designs too, which is great. Good luck to everyone who has entered, and we'll be announcing the winners soon.
Here are the stories from across the city.
It looks like you've been enjoying hitting the gym again. Malcolm likes the new gym at Pudsey, and Irene has begun going to Holt Park Active. Bramley Day Services has their own cross trainer, which is always popular. People from Hillside Community Base have been taking part in an exercise group at Beeston Village Centre, and Bramley Day Services have been playing ball games. For people at Middleton Community Base, rugby sessions have been their exercise of choice, but the folk from the east of the city have enjoyed riding the adapted cycles at John Charles Centre for Sport. Well done to Harry from our specialised services who has taken up roller skating lessons. Something he's always wanted to do for a long time. Also, congratulations to people at Richmond Hill Community Base who have just completed a 12-week healthy lifestyle programme. This was run by People in Action and One New Leads to learn how to make healthy eating choices and take part in exercise classes. Finally, a massive round of applause to Debbie, who has started to eat healthier. She is also going to the gym and throwing a bit of lightweight into the mix. She has already lost a few pounds after only a short time. Debbie said she thinks the power plate is fun because it makes her teeth chatter when she smiles. Our mouths were watering at the sight of all the wonderful things that you've been cooking and baking over the past few months. It looks like pizzas are very popular, but congratulations to Kirsty who made Yorkshire pudding for the first time during her stay at Rainel Respite. Aidan baked buns at Naban Community Base, Nicola made a fabulous Victoria sponge cake at Waterloo, and just look at the beautiful strawberries and cream cake that Alice was supported to create at Bramley Day Service. Jordan very kindly prepared cottage pie at Armley Vicarage for when his friends returned from their day services. And David from Richmond Hill Community Base enjoyed the four-week course he attended at Ministry of Food in Leeds Market. Chloe started her new jigsaw at Armley Vicarage, whereas David has just finished his at Bramley Day Service. There's been a lot of spring planting going on, especially at Holt Park Community Base and Rothwell Day Service, where Tom has been planning where to plant the seeds in the garden. We're sure the gardens are going to look beautiful. There's a lot of great work going on with Bright Sparks Drama Group, preparing for the next show. And Jake at Bramley Day Service loves his music session. People at Potter Newton have been enjoying working with Pyramid of Arts, and at Blackgates Community Base they've been painting ornaments. On a more relaxing note, the sensory room at Bramley Day Service is a lovely place to chill amongst the music and twinkling lights, whereas at Airborough Community Base they've been taking part in online yoga sessions. Many of you have been enjoying the sunshine when it was here. Trips out have included a visit to the Marina Cafe at Appley Bridge, Golden Acre Park, Gipton Old Fire Station and Cafe, a farm, Kirkstall Abbey for a picnic walk, the Peace Hall in Halifax, and the people staying at Rainel Respite Service went to Thompson's Fish Restaurant near York. the folk from Specialised Services couldn't resist Leap One's club night at Pop World, and a group of ladies went to the theatre to see Joseph and his amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat. It's great to see so many of you enjoying the football at Ellen Road, if not the results. Mel and Richard still cheering even though they got soaked in the rain. Of course, it's not just football you enjoy. Stephen loved watching the Rhinos playing at Emerald Headingley Stadium, as did Babs, who was lucky enough to catch up with some of the players. Paul from Endercliff went along to Leeds Arena with Alex Snow. They watched local lad Josh Warrington beat Kiko Martinez and pick up the International Boxing Federation World Championship featherweight title. Paul was pretty happy to get to meet Josh, Kiko, and Josh's coach, Sean O'Hagan. He also came home with a signed boxing glove. Happy birthday to everyone who celebrated their special day since our last newsletter in January, especially Stephen and Aidan, who both turned 50, Gerald, who turned 60, and Arthur, who celebrated his 78th birthday, and Alan, who is 80 years young. How lucky is Ben, who celebrated his birthday with a pamper morning? Congratulations to the amazing Sammy Joe, who has, for the first time since August 2019, used her walking frame to complete a full lap around Rothwell Day Service. What a wonderful achievement. And on the 15th of February, Angelman Day, Lucy enjoyed giving away biscuits to people at Bramley Day Services to raise awareness of a rare neurogenetic disorder called Angelman Syndrome. Well done to Chris, who has started his new job on the reception desk at Beeston Village Centre. He's such a friendly man, we are sure he'll do a great job. Max enjoyed her first day back at Henshaw's Art and Craft College. She made pottery and jewellery, and she has also had her annual health check recently, which is a very big personal achievement for her. Another person who has achieved a personal goal is Mark. He recently moved into a new supported living service after a good few years at Railsfield. His support team said he was a bit nervous on the day, but they are sure he'll soon be charming his new neighbours and staff, and from the look of the photo, they are right. Samantha finally got to celebrate Christmas with her family, and well done to everyone at Bramley Day Service who joined in the world's biggest coffee morning and raised £293 for Macmillan Cancer Support. Also well done to everyone at our specialised services who had a great day raising money for Comic Relief on Red Nose Day. Middleton Community Base welcomed in the Chinese New Year. This year is the year of the tiger, according to the Chinese zodiac. To celebrate, they painted a beautiful picture for the wall before having a Chinese meal for lunch, starting with spring rolls and potato crackers.
These are your diary dates.
And save the date, Leeds Learning Disability Week, 13th to the 17th of June. We are crossing our fingers that this year we may see the return of some of our favourite outdoor events, including the football competition, supported sponsored walk, and picnic in the park, COVID permitting. 9th of August, Aspires Commonwealth Games. We know Pudsey Community Base have been practising their botcher skills, but now it looks like they are going to have some serious competition as people at Holt Park and Garth of Community Base are also honing their skills. Should make for a great event. And now for some sad news. We are sad to report the deaths of Stephen Richardson, Safiq Dad, Jonathan Warren, Suzanne Reed, and Stephen Flynn. They were all much loved and will be missed by those whose lives they've touched. Our deepest condolences go out to their families and friends. One of our colleagues, Jackie Banks, sadly passed away last year. Jackie was the cleaner at Rothwell Day Service for many years and was thought of very highly by all who knew her. A service of remembrance was held for Jackie recently, and Claire Davey from Rothwell Day Service has written a lovely poem in Jackie's memory. Jackie Banks was one of a kind. An angel, a saint comes to mind. All that knew her would certainly agree that never a kinder soul would you see. Jackie will be missed every day by us all, for her presence was huge though her stature was small. There's a peace in knowing she is now at rest, for Jackie was and always will be the best. We would like to wish Eileen Cox, Lynn Saunders, Tim Snell, Julie Cooper, Tracy Ramsden, Jean McInnes, Cindy Bonner, Alison Barr, Caroline Terry, Janet Budden and Stephen Jackson all the best for long, healthy and happy retirements. This bumper crop of long service retirees have clocked up an astonishing 351 years of service supporting people with learning disabilities in Leeds, with Janet and Stephen achieving 90 years between them. And finally, thank you to Alex Gedger's family for the very kind donation to Kirkstall Community Base in memory of Alex. Don't forget to tell us about your good news stories so we can let everyone know about them. Please send them to Carol Benson at newsletter@aspirecbs.org.uk. The next edition of Your News will be out in July 2022.
Thank you for watching Your News.